So today we kind of have an abnormal colony condition again. Seems to be what I do most in these videos, but anyways, we have a condition called laying workers here, and it's exactly that. Previous in this kind of colony's history, something has gone wrong with a queen has failed, and that can happen for a whole whack of reasons, so we won't quite go into that, but at the end of the day, queen has died, and what's now happened is those worker bees have failed to replace her, and with that there's no brood, no queen laying any eggs, so the workers have been broodless for a amount of time, and after a certain amount of time, the workers then start to develop their own ovaries, and they don't quite have the plumbing the queens do, so they can't go out and mate, and basically they start developing their ovaries, and because they can't mate, they lay unfertilized eggs, which become drones, and basically this colony just turns from a queen-right colony into mostly workers, into mostly drones, and then peters out from there. So it's kind of an end-of-a-line situation for your bees and your bee colony there. But we're going to go in and see kind of the signs and the symptoms, and afterwards we'll show you what you can do with that. So we'll head on into this colony. We do treat it like a regular colony. We smoke it. We take the lid off, the inner cover, put that at the front. Give them a couple puffs of smoke, and we'll get right on it. So I'll skip that second frame because there's not much activity on that one. But pulling out the first frame, we're already seeing pretty much everything that says laying workers. So you can see just the population of adult bees are mostly drones. So this has kind of already gone on for a while where the worker bees have laid a lot of drones, raised those, and then they've hatched and kind of become a part of the population. You can see here too, this is one of the only few drones here that's actually of a regular size. So this one right below my finger has hatched out of an actual drone-sized cell. And as it walks by other drones, get a good look at just how small these other drones are compared to this big boy. And the reason for that is, again, these laying workers, they can't mate, but they think they can. And so they're laying unfertilized eggs in what should be worker-sized cells, cells for fertilized eggs. So a lot of these drones are a lot smaller just because they've come from those worker-sized cells. And in the middle here, you can actually see where that's going on. So these cells are raised, kind of looks very rigid, and they're kind of, you know, like little mountains here and there, mountain ridges. And that's basically, again, because the drones are larger than the worker bees, they've had to draw those out. So we're seeing lots of that here. Another couple of cool things you can see, some of these larvae have died. And are starting to turn a little off color. Again, another big sign and symptom of laying workers, and the reason for that is, as you can see on this frame, there's not a lot of worker bees and lots of drones. The worker bees are what take care of those larvae. So these larvae aren't getting the attention they need, and they're starting to die of probably starvation, something like that, just neglect. So that's another good sign symptom of the laying workers there. I'll flip this over. See what's going on, but pretty much the same as the other side. So we'll go into the next frame and should be more going on. We're kind of getting now more into the middle of the cluster. So here we go again, just lots of drones, small drones. We're seeing a lot more drone laden worker sized cells. Here's something kind of interesting. So they, even though they have gone into that full laying worker mode, you can see right here a bunch of queen cups, which they're trying to raise queens out of. It's a bit of a last-ditch effort. They're actually more than likely drone larvae in there. They're just kind of going through the motions and trying the best they can to salvage the situation. But that's what's happening here. They will cap those out, but a queen will not hatch out of there. And the only last thing to note is, and this is always a tricky one to talk about, because it's not so much if you see eggs laid as if they were laid by a worker that
that it means it's laying workers. It's more of a, you see eggs laid, like in a patch down in here. So a queen laid egg should be almost directly at the bottom looking back up at you. But a lot of these worker laid eggs are gonna be laid on the side of the comb, and there's gonna be multiple eggs per cell. So that is something to kind of raise your attention. There are other instances, like in the springtime, when the queen's really ready to go, if there's a weak colony, sometimes she'll lay more than one egg per cell. So just seeing eggs laid in this orientation and this number doesn't mean 100% you have laying workers. You have to go and see those other signs and symptoms, like the drone larva in the worker-sized cells and all that sort of stuff. So I'll get a good little shot of that. And again, you can see some other things, like some drones that are starting to hatch out and are not making it, just again, because nobody, there's very few workers and not very many of them are able to take care of them on their way out. Turn, and we've seen both sides of that, so we'll set that one aside. I'll just have one more little peek at the next frame. See what's going on there. Oh, and here we actually are able to see, so here's a queen cell that has hatched. There's a hole chewed out right through the bottom of it, and a hole through the side. So this obviously happened a while ago. The queen hatched out, and now, just to get rid of it, the bees were starting to chew down the sides and tear that cell apart. So obviously they tried, something hatched out, but that didn't work. And then it just progressed to this point of laying workers. So that's kind of very interesting again. But again, just the same sort of laying worker pattern. So the only other one sort of sign and symptom, unfortunately we didn't have here because this wasn't a very strong colony to begin with. Sometimes this laying worker pattern, you'll see it in the honey supers, especially at the bottom, that bottom honey super that's right on top of that queen excluder. Pretty much any time you see this sort of thing above the queen excluder, that totally, you can rule out a drone laying queen and go straight to laying workers. They'll continue that laying worker pattern all throughout the colony, since those worker bees can get through that queen excluder. But just unfortunately this was a little weaker, so we're not able to show you that there. The last thing to kind of talk about here is what you can do with this. Again, this colony here is a bit of a lost cause. You can introduce as many queens as you want to it. They're not going to accept a queen. So when we have a colony like this, the best thing to do is either take this colony away to the edge of the woods or something like that, and just shake out all these bees. And that the workers who have kind of developed their ovaries are a little heavier or stuff like that. The thinking is that they'll kind of be left where you shook them. And then all the other good productive bees will be able to fly back to the colony and get back into it. But while you shake those out, you bring back the colony and introduce a nuc that you made up from another colony. So put a nuc in there with good proper queen laid brood, and either bring a queen with it or introduce a queen to that. And that should kind of solve that problem for that colony. So you're using this colony and kind of keeping some of those bees that are part of that colony, but you're having to introduce other bees to it in order to kind of normalize it and make it worth keep on going. And that's our laying workers. Hey guys, so we have another picture of Sacbrood here, which is another disease. It's a stress disease, which you typically see in the spring, but normally your bee colonies, as they go through the year and get stronger and healthier, will grow out of this. If you do want to take action, the best thing to do is requeen the colony, and that typically kind of resolves that. The picture you're looking at is early stages of this Sacbrood disease. As you can see, the larva is in the cell, has kind of traveled to the bottom of the cell and is curling up through the middle of the cell and kind of poking out to the top of that cell. That's a typical sort of shape of Sacbrood. Some say it's like a Shriner's shoe with that curve. Another way to diagnose that is just to pull that out with a pair of tweezers or anything like that and grab that, and then you'll see why they call it Sacbrood. There will be kind of a juicy part of the larva that looks like a sac. Everything's kind of turned to mush in the middle.
Just another quick little test. If you're confused between this and some sort of foul brood, is to stick a twig in there, pull that out, and hopefully you don't see any sort of ropey bits. And you can check that out online, what that should look like. But that's Sacbrood. Something to notice, but not the biggest pest or disease out there.